Now, another request we've heard from a lot of you guys is that right now it's a little bit challenging to move data in and out of App Engine. If you've got a lot of data, such as something in an existing database that you have on site, it can be hard to get that into App Engine's data store to start playing with and testing apps. So in response to that, tonight we're excited to announce our large-scale data import tool. This tool makes it really easy to move gigabytes of data into the data store in App Engine. You can start, stop, or resume your upload, and it handles errors that you might encounter as you're sending a lot of data, possibly over the course of a few days. Now, we're also working on an export tool, so it'll be just as easy for you to move the gigabytes of data you have in App Engine off and have a local backup copy. After all, it's your data. You should be able to do anything you want with it, to move it on or off as easily as we can make it. Now, the next feature I'd like to talk about briefly is particularly exciting to our enterprise developers. One thing we've heard from a lot of enterprise developers is they'd like a way to connect to the data that they have behind the firewall, stuff they haven't put in the cloud yet. In fact, we've heard from a lot of enterprise developers that they feel like they're being forced to choose. To choose between having applications that are easy to access in the cloud or applications that have the security of data behind the firewall. Well, we don't think you should have to choose. So tonight, I'm excited to announce the Secure Data Connector, or SDC. SDC makes it easy to have policy-controlled access in your applications to your on-premise data that's behind the firewall. Now, before I get into a more complicated description of how SDC works, I want to show you an example of SDC in action. Now, I'm also a manager here at Google, so I sometimes have to manage my reports, and I might need to see a report of my employees. So here we have a sample spreadsheet where we've imported some employee data that lives behind the firewall. Now, this data here has been changed, so this is not real employee data to protect people's privacy. Get off the phones now. But it is actually coming from behind our firewall. You can see from the URL, this is actually coming from within Google. Now, we've set up a policy on this spreadsheet that says that I, Kevin Gibbs, can access this spreadsheet, and through the spreadsheet can access that URL. The policy is very specific. And due to that policy and the fact that I'm logged in, which you can see in the upper right-hand side, I can actually do a query in the spreadsheet, and the query will be sent through Google down to inside the firewall. So let me try a query here. And you can see it'll actually send out that URL and return some new data. Now, that's really, once a page loads, that's really all there is to it. As you can see, the import data command's got a URL in there, and the secure data connector tells it how to find the right URL and return that data. That's it. That's all you have to do. And really, that's part of the beauty of SDC. It's really easy for you to set this up and gain access to your firewall data. You don't have to set up a proxy, you don't have to change your VPN or do anything like that. In fact, sort of the magic of SDC is that you can use this app in the airport and gain access to that firewall data. Now, I'd like to now tell you a little bit more about how SDC actually works, because it's pretty important given the security involved in what it's doing. SDC is built around having an agent that runs inside the firewall and a set of servers that run at Google. The SDC agent then connects, you run the SDC agent, and it makes a connection to our servers in the cloud. And that gives the servers at Google access, policy-controlled access, to the data that you've chosen to expose. That means that Google App Engine applications, gadgets, and spreadsheets can all have access to the data that you specify in your policy. We wanted SDC to be straightforward to use while still giving you the security that you needed to run your application. And so that led to a few design goals that we have for SDC. One, we wanted SDC to be simple. We wanted it to be simple for you to use. And for that simplicity, it was embodied with two things. One, we wanted to make it easy for you to run the agent. All you need to do is take our agent software and install it on any Linux machine within the firewall. Once you do, it'll connect and authenticate with Google Apps and make the data available to anything else at Google that you've granted that permission to the data. Within applications, whether it's a spreadsheet or an App Engine app or what have you, it's very easy to use SDC as well. All you need to state is a URL that you want to reach, and Google will automatically route it down through the agent within your firewall. Now, the next goal with SDC was security. Obviously, for a tool like this, making it as secure as possible is one of the most important considerations. That's why all the data that you send with SDC is encrypted with SSL. But it also means that we wanted to make it secure for your organization. That's why when you use SDC, you don't have to open a new port in your firewall or change anything about the settings of your network. It only makes outbound connections to Google. And finally, we wanted the policies that you use in SDC to be very specific. That's why the policies are at the application, user, and URL level. That means you have very fine-grained support over exactly who can access any data that you've exposed. Now, the final consideration we have for SDC is we want it to be open. So to achieve that, we've actually open sourced the entire SDC agent. You can go and check out the code now and audit it yourself if you'd like. We've also chosen to use the OAuth protocol when authenticating from the server to at Google down to your agent software. The OAuth protocol is an open standard that has seen a lot of public scrutiny, and we think that it represents the best practices in authentication. Now, I've shown you a really simple example of SDC. I'd like to now call up Mark from Oracle, who's going to show you a real-world example of using SDC to connect to Siebel data. Mark?
Right.